Hey, what's going on? This is Don, and welcome to another Cinema 4D tutorial. And today I'm going to be showing you how to do a realistic interior render like this one in just a few minutes. And this is a free scene, so you can go ahead and download this from my blog as well. I will place the link below the video. This is what it looks like in Cinema 4D before any lighting, just the scene with some materials. And this is just some of the samples from my own texture packs, which I sell on my website. But if you want to follow along easier with the tutorial, they are included in the scene. It's just a few samples, so you can follow along with this tutorial. Okay, there's only going to be one light in the scene, and it's going to be a physical sky. So let's get that. And it's going to come in the center of the scene here. What we want to do is match up the direction of the sun, which is this green circle here. We want to match this up to where the light source is on our model. So in this case, it's this window over here. This is roughly in the right direction right now, but maybe I want to angle it a bit more toward the actual room itself. So I could just rotate the sky object, just kind of like this, or go into the actual physical sky, and then in the time and location settings, I can change this around to get a slightly different look. So maybe if we go for 11 a.m. instead, it's going to be more angled this way. And I think this will be fine just as an example. Okay, and just jumping back into our camera here, you can see the whole scene looks a bit strange now. It's kind of dark. So maybe I would just disable this in the preview window so it looks more normal. But I can do an initial render and see, we have this kind of thing here. So I like the positioning of the sun. We have the sun rays hitting the floor over here. But this is just the starting point. So let's go ahead and actually make this look nice. And we're going to do that using global illumination. So if I go to my render settings, I'm going to go to effect and global illumination. And this is the kind of settings you want to use for now. The primary method is going to be left at irradiance cache. This is going to be the initial light bounce in our scene, and I'm going to lower the samples to low for now, just for preview purposes. And if I go to the second tab here, I will do the same here too. Let's go for low, and I'm going to go even lower. Let's go for -4 for the minimum rate and -2 for the max rate. And I can do an initial render with the first level of GI enabled. And see what that does to our scene. Okay, and this is what that first level of global illumination is going to do. The scene is still too dark, but now the colors look right. We just need to go and brighten up the rest of the scene and create more light bounces. And by the way, for the light outside to come into the room properly and work well with global illumination, you have to have what's called a portal material on your window over here. So this is this transparent material which you are looking at. So just going into this is very simple. It's just a regular material with the transparency enabled so that we can let some light through. And then in the illumination settings, you want to enable this GI portal switch here, and this is going to tell global illumination which way the light should come into the room. Also, I have the luminance channel enabled here, which if it was disabled, I would not be able to turn this into an area light. So with this enabled, you can also turn this on. And this is going to help optimize the GI settings and give you a better overall render. Okay, so you want to make sure you create that material and apply that to the light source in your scene. Okay, but going back to the GI settings, let's go and add the second level of light bounces. So in the secondary method, we want to go and set this to light mapping. And by default, the maximum depth is set to 16. This means how many times the light is going to bounce around in the scene. I'm going to leave this at that default value. But in the light mapping settings, maybe I could lower the path count to about 3000 or so, just for preview purposes. And then when we do the final render, we could put that back up again. And I'm going to tick radio city maps just to speed up the calculation as well. Okay, we can jump back into our camera and let's do another render and see where we are now. And this is the result. So as you can see, comparing it to the previous example where we only had one level of GI, with the extra light bounces, this looks more natural and more realistic. However, it's still too dark overall as a scene. And there's a few things you can do to improve this. You could just go to the original light source and increase the intensity. So maybe I'll go for something like 200 for the sky and the same for the sun as well. But this is not going to make a major difference in this particular scene because it's a large room with a fairly small opening over here. So there just isn't that much light coming in to begin with anyway. So what I like to do is to go to the render settings and use color mapping to brighten my scene. So if I go to effect and color mapping, I want to change this dark multiplier to something quite high, like 10. And this is going to brighten my scene. I'm also going to untick HSV model here because this tends to suppress the highlights too much, which makes the scene look a bit too flat. It might be worth just experimenting with the color mapping controls and see what they do for your scene. But here it's quite straightforward. We're just, making the dark parts of the image brighter. Okay, and our render also looked quite splotchy in some areas, not very clean overall. So we want to go ahead and increase the render settings as well before we do a final render. So if I go back to the general tab in GI, I'm going to go to medium samples here, and let's do the same in the irradiance cache. And light mapping, maybe we can still leave at 3000. It should look fine. And we could go to the anti-aliasing, go for maybe best, let's say 1x1, 2x2 with a threshold of 5. I think this would give us a pretty clean looking render. So let's go ahead and see what this looks like now with those changes. Okay, and this would be the final result. As you can see, much brighter and more natural looking than before. And if we compare this to the previous versions, you can see the progression from start to finish. And there was another version of this I did with essentially the same thing, except there was some reflection on the floor panels. So this will be in that material, the wood floor material, just with reflection enabled this time, and the roughness set to 20%, and there is a texture in the layer color to break up the reflection to give you this final look. But that's it, some techniques on how to do some realistic interior renders in Cinema 4D. I hope you learned something new, and if you have any questions, then just leave your comments below the video. And also, check out the store, the texture packs, car paint, element 3D shaders, and so on. Maybe there'll be a few things that you are interested in, but thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.